On your SLR camera, your apertures don't actually live in the camera, they live in the lens. I'm going to show you what I mean using my old Mamiya. The principle is exactly the same on a modern DSLR. Now, looking through the lens, I can either have a very wide aperture or hole in the lens, or I can adjust it and make it smaller. Now there's a little tiny pinprick. Obviously, if I've got a big hole in the lens, there's loads of light rushing in. If I have a little tiny pinprick of a hole like that, there's very little. And in all the different places in between, I'm varying the amount of light that's getting into the camera. On a DSLR, it's just the same. You control your apertures with this F number. On your camera, it may be displayed somewhere else, but it's still the F number. Whoever came up with these numbers, they need a slap because they're back to front. A low F number means a big hole, so there's tons of light coming in. A high F number means the opposite, a little tiny hole, so there's not very much light coming in. So when we talk about a small aperture, we mean a high number. High number, small hole, not much light. Now, your aperture does something else as well, which is much more interesting and creative. It also is the main control for your depth of field. Depth of field is how much of the picture you've got sharp and in focus. For example, this wheel here, I could take a picture of this and have this nice and sharp, but the other wheel's all soft and out of focus. I'm going to set a low F number. That's a wide aperture, a big hole. That gives me a shallow depth of field. Like this. If I change that aperture and I have a little tiny pinprick of a hole, I've got lots of depth of field. They're all sharp and in focus. Now, in order to do that, obviously I'm changing the size of the hole, so therefore I'm going to mess about with the exposure. Don't worry about the exposure side of it for the minute. I just want you to know that an aperture is a hole in the lens you can vary the size of, and it has an impact on exposure, but it also has a creative impact on your depth of field.